Hey everyone, Nick Taylor here from MenajErie Studio. And today we're gonna be doing something really cool. We're actually going to be building our own video editing PC. Stay tuned, let's check it out. Okay, so today we have something a little bit different. We need a new video editing machine for one of our editors in our studio. And I decided, as I do with all of our PCs, to build it myself. One of the advantages to building your own PC is that you get to select exactly the parts that you want, and oftentimes you're saving $500 or more off of something that's pre-built for you and may not even have the specs that you're looking for. So my budget for this build was right around $1,500, so not a huge budget, but we were able to get something really powerful that'll do a great job for Premiere editing and a little bit of After Effects work. So let's start off with the most important part of any video editing computer, and that is of course the CPU. We decided to go with the Intel Core i7 9700K. Now the reason I went with the 9700K is really because it was about the same price point as the 8700K. The 9900K, although it has some impressive statistics, I just did not see the vast improvement based on the vast price difference between the two at the time. A lot of the research I did was through a company called Puget, and they build custom computers for video editing, After Effects, AutoCAD, and sort of use-specific scenarios. A lot of people have been using AMD processors, and I have nothing against AMD. I have just had better luck with performance in Adobe programs using Intel CPUs and Nvidia graphics cards. And so that brings me to my next piece of equipment here that's sort of crucial to the build, and that is the graphics card. I went with the GTX 1660 Ti. A lot of people might ask, you know, why I didn't go for the RTX series, and really it was the budget on this computer. The 1660 Ti is just a really good price for the performance you're getting. Next up, I would say the motherboard is important. So this is the Z390, which is pairing with our ninth generation i7 here. We should be good to go with this. ASUS is a brand I've used time and time again. They're a great brand, very reliable. This obviously does not come with a stock fan, so you're gonna need a CPU cooler. I chose the Hyper 212 from Cooler Master. This was, again, a little bit cheaper, but had some great reviews. Over here we have the power supply. It's a 650 watt power supply. It is fully modular. It's from a company called Seasonic. This is their Focus Plus Gold Edition. It has a 10-year warranty, great reviews. And then we went with 32 gigs of memory. This is from Corsair. This is their Vengeance LPX series. It's two 16 gig sticks. I probably will end up getting another pack and upping this to 64 gigs, but again, staying within that $1,500 price point, this will do the trick for us. Okay, so next up are our hard drives, or rather our solid state drives. Right here we have the main drive, which is the Samsung 970 Evo. This is an M.2 drive. It is incredibly fast, works great. This is the 500 gigabyte, which should be enough for us to install the operating system. We also have the SanDisk SSD Plus. This is a 1 terabyte, really good price on this. And finally, all of this has to go into something. Over here we have the ThermalTake V200TG, but this comes with a 3-fan configuration in the front for plenty of airflow. It also has a tempered glass side, so you can see all of your cool stuff that you just put in here. I'm pretty sure the fans have RGB LEDs built into them that you can change the color. All that stuff, of course, is not incredibly important, but ThermalTake makes some great cases. And again, this one had good reviews. I think it's gonna do us just fine. Okay guys, those are all the components that we're gonna be using in our brand new video editing build for under $1,500. Of course, if you have any questions, please leave it in the comments below. I'm gonna go ahead and get started building this, and we will see you later.